Welcome back to Computer Time.
Welcome back to Green Screens again. Yet again. I know I just said that last time. Go with it.
We cleaned up the first environment that was based on SR388.
Mm-hmm.
We cleaned them stabilizers.
So all of those... As I listened to the briefing, my thoughts turned to Adam. The real Adam understood me well. Way better than that computer ever would.
Or any other,
woman can't understand me like Adam. Anyway, any objections, lady? He would end orders by saying, any objections, lady? He knew I wouldn't disagree. That was just his way of noting our trust. I wonder if I can trust this computer too. Any objections? He's fucking just being a jerk with you. He's like, do you want to change anything? You're good though, right? You're good? Okay, good. All right, right on. All right, awesome. What am I trying to say? He's
being condescending.
He's being very condescending. He's being very, there's another word.
Misogynistic?
There's a better word. It's not misogynistic. He's not mansplaining. He's being very, it's when you treat someone like a kid.
Condescending.
There's a different word. Hang on a minute.
Ageist.
No. It's, fucking... Wow. Good stuff. It's being very... I have learned the identity of our mystery saboteur. Samus, it's an X mimicking you. I have named it the SAX.
Or SAX.
I have named it the R2-D2. I believe the SAX came from the capsule containing your infected suit parts. It used a power bomb to escape the quarantine bay.
Because Adam let it.
I didn't get what you were getting at there for a second. That explosion breached the capsules containing all of the X that started this disaster. X all over the floor. It's gooped all over my face.
X going to give it to you.
Yeah. But the SAX is definitely our biggest worry right now. The SAX is mimicking you at full power. You can't face it. Damn.
Yeah, that's why this game has a horror element to it, I feel.
If you see the SAX, just fucking run. Just don't even think about fighting.
Yeah.
You are still very vulnerable to cold and unexpected side effects to the Metroid vaccine.
Mm-hmm. That's the cool thing, too. Like, they wrote that in as, like, yeah, Metroids are also susceptible to ice, which they were, and it's... why you're susceptible to ice, because they have the Metroid vaccine.
Yeah, it's, like Metroids, you can be frozen by an ice beam, which he fucking definitely has.
Yep.
Stay away. If you see it, just run, like I said. HQ says they have the bomb data ready in the data room.
Just blow up every fucking thing.
Bombs will help you find a way out if the SAX traps you. Okay. The data room is here, but it's sealed by a level 1 tuner hatch.
Oh. How unfortunate.
Not a level 1 tuner.
You'll have to find the security room and release the level 1 locks. Not like I could do it for you.
You'll have to XYZ summon with these level 1 monsters. Anyway.
Synchro.
Yeah, you'll have to find it on your own somehow, Samus. So, first, find the security room and unlock level 1 hatches. Then go to the data room and get that bomb. Is your objective clear?
No.
Keep an eye out for the SAX.
I mean, she's super hot, even though she's a creepy alien.
I mean, look at that ass.
Actually, no, she's probably safe. I hope we have an encounter during this.
You hope?
I hope.
I mean, I thought it was a scary mic.
It is a scary, but I hope
it was a scary. One second.
Where are you going?
Nowhere.
Where are you going? Shoot, 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 shoot. Do we want to go here?
Maybe. You're telling me, Mike, this is your adventure.
This is Bugland.
This is your time.
Oh, gross.
Oh, dear.
Oh, that's not good. There's nothing I can do about those. I think those need to be frozen.
Mm-hmm.
Ah! And there's these creepy pupas all over the place.
Very... So Adam was being very... patronizing.
Patronizing also works, yes.
So that was the word that was in my noggin that I couldn't think of.
He was being very patronizing.
Any objections? Miss Little Tiny Baby. Goo Goo Gaga. Do you get it? Goo Goo Gaga. Fucking get on the mission.
Is baby going to cry?
Fuck. No!
Well, she's dead now. How do you feel about that?
You've removed
Goo Goo Gaga, you going to die now?
Now she's cured of her suit. Because the suit's a virus, right?
All it took was death.
Isn't it just like this suit is killing her?
It's not killing her. She's fused to it. That's why they call it Metroid Fusion. It's literally fused to her body.
It's funny. I don't know. The power suit, just on its own, is like a second skin to Samus. Which is pretty cool.
How she feels about it, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, fuck off, bug. That did not need to happen. Oh, we're taking hits and we're taking shits.
Taking mad shits. These guys are red, Mike.
Sam, why would you say something like that?
My god, I'm so insensitive. Noting their primary color.
Yeah, looks racist.
Motherfucker. There they go. Whoa, this guy's fucking, like...
making a beeline.
Dude, yeah.
This is a bee. Right?
Yep. Man, I couldn't have said it any better myself, Mike.
I don't know if we could have landed that joke any harder.
God damn it. God.
God,
crashed like a freaking freight train into your funny bone.
Is it the same train that the Chozo was riding?
Yeah.
I'm coming for the funny bone!
All aboard the funny train!
All aboard!
If you guys don't understand, then check out our Metroid Zero mission.
Yep, that's where it was.
Yep. Will all be clear.
The Chozo train.
The Chozo train. All aboard the Chozo train. Reminds me of Gears of War. We gonna play Gears of War in the show?
Maybe.
Can you play multiplayer on that game?
Yes, we can.
Ooh. Okay.
The thing was, I was actually trying to go for a job with Microsoft a long time ago. Okay, this is like a two-parter. The first part was... I got called out of the blue by a talent scout.
A talent?
Like a talent scout for... Okay. They were looking for people to come work on Gears of War 4.
Wow.
And they were specifically looking for a special effects artist, and that's not my background whatsoever. So I'm like...
One would say you don't have as much experience as the next person in special effects for video games.
Yeah, and I'm like, thank you for the offer, but I really don't think it's going to work out. And the other part, too, was like... They wanted somebody to move to Vancouver, which I wasn't ready and willing to do.
Oh my goodness. Well, they definitely gave you, like... Well, it's nice that they asked.
Yeah.
I think it's really cool.
Security room. There
you
go.
If you had the experience, you would have done it.
Yeah.
You would have done it.
But it wasn't a job I was going to be capable of
performing adequately. Yeah.
But then I was also up for a job to promote the game. And during that time, I picked up all the games, but have not played through them all yet. So we do have
them. The series is awesome, and I've always enjoyed Gears of War, the original Gears of War. That was done by... What developer was that again?
Gearbox, I believe.
No.
No?
No. That was done by... Not Gearbox.
Guillermo del Toro.
No. it's the same developer as Bulletstorm. But that developer...
You sure about it?
Yes. So, Gears of War... I'm going to look that up right now. It's not Gearbox, if I'm not mistaken. I never played Gears of War 4. I should check that out.
That's on Xbox One.
Yeah.
That's why.
Gears of War. Gears of War.
Is this the right way? This is the right way.
It's made by Epic Games.
Epic Games, there we go.
Yeah, so Epic. Epic made that game.
That's quite epic.
Yeah. Oh! there's four games in the Gears of War franchise. Five games? Gears of War 4, Gears of War Judgment, Gears of War 3, Gears of War 2, Gears of War, and then Gears of War Exile, which I don't even know which fucking console. I don't even know when that came out.
Oh, Data Room, we're getting the bombs!
Woohoo, we got the bombs! I looked up, and we have the bombs. It's good stuff. Bomb data download.
And we unlock the level 1 doors.
Morph into the ball and press 1 when Adam says you can.
When Adam says yes. Oh, did you see that?
Okay, we get it, Broly. Or with the green powers. With the green, I don't know, fuck it. People don't know what I'm talking about.
No. People don't get your hip lingo.
No.
More missiles.
They really just, they want you to have missiles. They're like, hey, here's as many missiles.
You see this? There's no going back.
You can't go back?
Nope.
That's fucked.
Yeah. Kind of like bad shit's going down.
It's kind of like,
kind of like something wants to kill us.
Wait, were we already confined in a chamber? Was the X thing in the room with us just now?
No.
Okay. Because I thought, like, damn, really? Like, if it was just in the room with us, that'd be really scary. Because it didn't give us any warning or anything.
Do I do this?
I think you got a wall kick? Or that, whatever.
Huh.
What if you just went behind that silver pillar and then you were just stuck back there forever?
That would suck. That'd be bad game design.
It'd be bad game design in... It's hard to even imagine a game where Nintendo does it badly.
Yeah, but it's very rare. Very rare. Alright, let's save here.
Save it up.
Save it up?
Yeah, I can't even think of a truly bad Nintendo game.
From a design standpoint.
Or just, we're just not fun, basically.
Well, there was Wii Music. That was infamously horrible.
I don't know if I played too much of Wii Music.
No, you probably didn't.
I played Wii Play.
It was god-awful.
Wii Play was fun.
Yeah, Wii Play was, but Wii Music was a travesty. It's one of the worst worst of E3 moments ever.
You sound like, you sound pretty salty about that game.
Oh, I am. Because I had to try to sell that piece of shit.
At Superstore.
Yeah, that's right.
My goodness.
Fuck.
God damn.
Ugh.
You are a master at Metroid, Mike.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, Wii Music did not do well. I believe that was definitely the worst of those Wii intro-type games.
That wasn't even an intro-type game. That was, like, later on in the Wii's life cycle.
Well, it still was, like, an intro-type game. Like, I know it's later on the Wii life cycle, but it's made by Nintendo, and it's got the Miis, so it's essentially a demo-type game. But I don't know.
But it was a full price game to start, and that's...
God, do I remember playing that game at all? Like,
I don't think you would have.
I just remember, like, weird, bad trumpet and stuff. Like,
yeah, that's the one.
It was like, bam, 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 bam. I don't remember.
That's very, very true.
Wow. So damn, I somehow managed to take it out of my memory.
Well, that's what therapy's for, Sam. To uncover traumatic experiences in your life. Like Wii Music.
Like Wii Music. My God. There was only 4 instruments. Yeah. You just like...
I wasn't ever safe.
Go really crazy.
Okay, we're making our way.
We're doing it. Dude, just calm down.
Dude, like, stop with your grabby hands.
Stop being so grabby. That guy is like the embodiment of Adam. He's just like, ugh, Samus.
Be more of a Kingler.
A Kingler? A Pokemon? Crabby. Instead of a Krabby, you gotta be a Kingler.
Oh, I'm falling through the force.
Bat. Oh. No.
That was a bat. That was a sheepy. Can you give it...
Put on the screen.
I don't know what you gave it, but you gave it something good.
Awesome, for sure. Calm down, Samus. Don't die. Oh, my God.
Yes, I'm trying again. Get out of my face.
Try one more time, Mike. Get in there. You can do it, Mike. I believe in you.
I believe in me, too.
I believe in you.
I believe in the me that believes in you that believes in me.
I believe in you. I just keep saying that over him.
We're running out of time, unfortunately.
Yeah, we're getting close to the end of our time here with Metroid Zero, with Metroid fucking Fusion.
Yeah. I want to come back to this.
This game looks like a delight, and I think you're having a great time playing it.
I am.
And will you always be collecting those parasites to get health?
Yes, always.
That's really weird.
Why would it not?
I think it's strange looking.
Well, that's our life now.
You are a weird ex-parasite person, man.
Exactly. There's no going back.
There's no going back to the past to play those shitty games and suck ass.
Get a little bit further than I did when I last died.
Let's see if you can't figure that one out a little bit more. There you go. Give it that 1-2 shot, Mike.
1-2 shot.
Yeah, dude. Killing it. Boob, boob.
Boom, boom, bam.
Boob, boob, bam. Use those missiles.
The fact that it takes 2 missiles to kill them is a little bit ridiculous right now.
It's a little much. I mean, most little enemies at the start of Metroid games are like, pop 1 missile, done. Who cares, right?
I guess because they got armor on their bodies.
And they're like, whoa, we're super badass because we survived SR388 and now we're here.
This is more of a tropical region. This isn't a world we've been to before, I don't think. Oh, shit.
Yeah, this is definitely strange. Like,
there we go. That's some good stuff.
Is it just like the spaceship looks like this, or is the spaceship, like, was it designed?
It was designed to host different environments for testing and breeding purposes and shit like that.
True.
And then there's these weird guys.
These guys are experts?
Well, they're being mimicked by expertites. So nothing we're encountering right now is truly the species it is. It's all ex-parasites.
Oh, that's really weird.
All right.
Damn.
Yeah.
Well, you shot a whole bunch of things.
I have shot a whole bunch of things.
And you shot many a caterpillar.
Mm-hmm.
You've done it.
But, yeah, we should probably end the episode. I'm going to keep playing as we do our...
Yeah, Mike's just having fun. So, anyways, guys, we have been playing Metroid games all month, for your viewing pleasure, also for our
gaming pleasure.
Our own gaming pleasure, absolutely, because, like, I never played this, I never played Metroid Other M, Mike's never really seen Metroid Prime. Not all of Metroid Prime.
And Metroid 2 Return of Samus was new for both of us.
Exactly, that's totally new.
And essentially why we wanted to start this Metroid month, because Return of Samus is getting its remake, and it's by the time of this episode, it's already here.
I mean, let alone the fact that Metroid Prime 4 is also coming out. It's also in development, and so... that made me fucking stupid excited when I saw that at E3, because Metroid Prime is one of my favorite game series, if not my favorite game series of all time.
Is something gonna happen here?
I don't know. But, anyways, but if you guys like this video, you can like and comment on it, and, let us know what you think. What is your favorite Metroid game? Is this your favorite Metroid game? Wouldn't be surprised if it was, because, like, this is one of Mike's favorite fucking Metroid games, basically. Oh, yeah. So, anyways, if you like our videos, it lets us know that you guys are enjoying the content, and it's just like, oh, cool, a little pat on the back for us, I guess. I don't know. Like, what the fuck does that mean? Anyway, so we'll see you guys in the next time.
Yep.
And
if you want us to play more of this, please let us know.
Yeah, absolutely.
We would absolutely love to.
Definitely. We will do that for you if you so choose, and yeah, we'll figure it all out. We'll see you guys later.
See you on the next time.